Variations on an Irish Tune, Violin 2. We're going to run through all of it first, and then we're going to go back, and I'll be picking it apart little by little so I can give you some pointers on that. Variations on an Irish Tune, Violin 2. It's from the very beginning, so we're going to include the rest there. Here we go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Play. This one's a little funky. Why? Because you need to do a fast retake. Like for you, you can do an open A string there. Excuse me. Go backwards there. Yeah. It's 109. Be sure it's divided. Okay. So your conductor should be going over that with you. odd number players, so stand, so C, 1, 3, 5, 7, etc. And you're gonna be playing the top note, that A. Even numbers, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, etc. You're gonna be playing the bottom note. You should be going over that with your conductors. You'll be split up. In the meantime, feel free to practice both of them. Not at the same time, just take alternate. At 1:12, there's an accent on the and of one. 1 and 2 and 3 4. Not 1 and 2 and 3 4 or 1 and 2 and 3 4. It's on the and. 1 and 2 and 3 4. So when you're playing it, it's gonna be kind of weird. So from 109. It's kind of hard to do it, I'm not gonna lie. 109. It was kind of funky. Practice it, take it home, practice it, because the accent is on an up bow, not on a down bow. It's a lot easier to do that on a down bow. Moving back, measure one. You come in on 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. For R1, for N1. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Whatever notes are. Okay, on this piece, your finger family is going to be major on the A string, major on the D string, for the most part. On the E string, should be minor there, yeah. Again, for the most part, when you get into the andante, it changes a little bit here and there. Got some C naturals in there somewhere, especially with the 9. At 17, you have a lot of measures, rest, so measure 9. Rest for 4 measures, measure 13, rest for 3 measures. And then you're gonna wanna really play out at 17. So 16 is gonna be 1, 2, play. Be sure your A da dee da dee dum. Your first finger on 17 is, so keep it regular on the tape. Da da dee dee e dee. So when you roll, you can either roll over from A on the G string, first finger, to E on the D string, first finger. You can either roll over, ba-dee-da-dee-dum, or you can put your finger in between both strings at the same time. And you can go from there, and you leave it there, and you don't have to worry about rolling over. It gets pretty interesting, okay? Because you have a B. First finger on the A string on the tape, B, A sharp, so B on the tape, and then low one on the A string, B, A sharp, F sharp, then back to B, 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 A, so B, A sharp, F sharp, B, B, A, G sharp, high 3 on the D string, G sharp, A, F sharp. So you have to take that home and practice that. Use a fingering that's on your music, that's written in. 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, open, 3, 4, 2. Up, up, 2 up bows. For that one's gonna be kind of weird. You don't want it to sound like it's a chord note. You don't want to go. Okay, that means you're gonna want to feel your bow catch. That's kind of hard to see from there. So you're gonna want to feel it. I don't know if you can tell the violin's moving. So you want to feel your bow catch the string twice for those two eighth notes at 21. Catch. So you want to push with your index finger. If it doesn't happen, don't freak out, but we need to hear two separate notes, not... That just sounds like a chord note, right? Not very interesting. Okay, you again use the fingering that's on your music. 1 1 2 1 1 open high three. So 1 2 and then regular three, but it's high. Keep it nice and open. It's gonna be your augmented finger family there. 1 1 2 1 1 open augmented 4 2. 1 1 2 1 1 open 3 4 2. Then it goes on from there. At 23. Use the finger that's written on there. 29, 30, use your fourth finger. Keep it nice and high. D, A, F sharp. It's gonna be quite a stretch for that. So keep it, if I were you, I would keep my third finger down there. D, da, 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 da. Then at 30, your fourth finger, you're gonna have to use it on the D string. You can either do, if you really want, do a fourth finger on both A's at 30. So E, D, open A. And then you have your F sharp, then fourth finger, and then open A. D, D, da, dum, bum. Open A, B, da, 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 dum, da. Or you can do it on, do your fourth finger on both. Or you can do what's written. I would just do what's written. Again, do what's written on the page at 34. It's gonna be a low two on the E string. You want that minor finger pattern there. Not major, unacceptable. You want that low two in there. Dee-da-dee-dum. Low two, I know it's kind of weird because you got your third finger, it's going to be kind of a stretch to get that second finger way back there, but you got to do it. Careful, and then at 38, it slows down. You're going to have to watch your conductor for that one. Might be different than what I'm playing for you right now. So at 38, one. It might be different than that. You're gonna have to watch your conductor and go over that in rehearsal. That's 37, 38. You have that little molto ritardando there. You're gonna slow down a lot. Molto means mucho, a lot. At 40, it slows down there. So you're gonna be quite a bit slower. You have a little rest there, someone plays there, then. So one and two, three, four, off. Be sure you get full value there. One and two, three, four, rest, two. Okay, at 42, you have a weird kind of rhythm there because you're coming on the end of two. So, G, E, F sharp, two, three, off. And bow, and three, one, two, and three, A, D. So G, E, F sharp, G, E, F sharp, two, three, rest, go, A, D, ma, na, mi, na, F sharp. Okay, at 41, hold on it. Rest, and. Then at 47, you split. It's a divisi. I think we've been over this already. No. So your conductor is going to split you up based on stance. So odd number stance are going to be playing the note that's on top, that D. And then even number chairs are going to be playing the bottom note. that B. So even number, so odd number chair is gonna be playing that D. So 1, 3, 5, etc. And the even number chairs are gonna be playing that bottom note. So it's divided there at 47. So the DIV, divisi, stands for divided. But not really, because yeah. So here's the top line. 2, 3, 4, 48. Then everybody's gonna be playing that A. On the fourth finger, please do that. 51, you're back to a, you're gonna slow down there at 48. You're gonna slow down. Then 51, you come back. Okay, 51, 2, 3, 52. 1, 2. At 55, it's quiet, so you're gonna wanna be, actually tremolo, generally you want to be, tremolo is when you go really fast. It's when you have those three little noodles, the three little lines above your notes there. At 55, so it's gonna be piano, so you're gonna be at the very tip of your bow. Anytime you do tremolo, ideally you're gonna want to be at the tip. So you're gonna be using more or less bow, or more or less weight, and closer, further away from the board, from the bridge. So in this case, 55, since it's piano, you're gonna want to be closer to the fingerboard, not over here, of course, but you know, pretty close. Use a little bit of bow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 56. 2, 3, 4, 57. 3, 4, and then you're gonna wanna add more. 2, 3, 4. So that was 59. So I played through that all the way up to 65. Yeah, when you reach 65, right before the tranquillo there, you have two little, it's for you guys, it's like this, two little lines like this, you know, me. So that's, those are called, call them railroad tracks, or technically called a caesura. Caesura means that you can completely stop playing and you watch your conductor for when you start again. Say, B, 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 nice and crescendo, and off, caesura, and your conductor is going to give you the tempo, and you're back to the same tempo, yeah. So, and then a tranquillo, G, E, then off, 68, and then 69, it's going to be really fast. So, I'm taking it one tempo, your conductor might take it a different tempo, it might be a little faster, it might be a little slower. So we're looking at 69. So we're gonna be open D. So this is not divided, this is not divisi. It means all you are gonna be playing your D and your A, open A, your open D and your open A strings together. 2, 3, 4. 7-1's kind of weird. Why? Because all of a sudden it asks you to play a grace note there. The little tiny note next to your open D and open A, that's gonna be your third finger, G, G, A. So it'll be before the beat, so A, 2, 3, 4, A, 2, 3, 4, 7, 1, G, A, G, A, it's very, very, very quick. That's what grace notes are. If I were you, is that divided? No, it's not divided. Okay, it's going to be kind of weird. So you can either, your conductor might want something different. You can either just go straight and do both at the same time. Or you can just pick the top one. You can leave your third finger down, or you can lift it. I think they're gonna want to take it a little faster. 77. Because you have like this weird, like almost like a tongue twister for your bow, Because you have down, and then you have an up bow, slur, and then a straight down bow. That's just something you have to take home and practice. Again, watch the, follow the bowing, follow the fingering that's on the music, at 80. It's really weird, I know, but you're just gonna have to practice it. If you can, add in that accent in there, so your up bow is gonna be a little bit louder. Dig into the string on that up bow. Your accent is when you have this sign underneath your notes. Okay. So the ones that have an accent, play them out a little bit. At 84, excuse me, 83 going into 84, you're gonna have to, you might have to do a little quick little retake there. We take down bow, it's gonna be kind of weird, I know, because it goes to down bow there. At 85, don't go crazy, I don't want to hear it. It's not very interesting, and you don't have the melody there. So, mezzo forte, you can back, so crescendo to the, then back off. To get lost in there, so you have to really track the your notes there. Rest. Oh, what's the right note? So at 93. Again, count, watch, as it gets really easy to get lost in there. But if you listen around you, you can kind of know where you are. At 93, you rest on beat one, and you're with the first violins there. So, and they play a high A. So 93, you give the melody to the low strings there. So they have they have a different part there. So 93, you have to be sure you rest there. Rest, ta. It's gonna be really easy to rest there at 93. So you gotta watch your conductor, listen around you. So we don't rest, you go crazy. No, don't do that. Count, watch, listen, take your time. It's not as fast as you think it is, especially at 93. Again, follow the fingering that's given in your music. So we're going to skip 93, go straight to 101. Follow your fingering. It's the major pattern on the D string and the A string. Started this whole thing. 101, pretty straightforward. Be sure to use your fourth finger where it asks you, like at 103. B da do da do da do. 2, 3, 4. Don't use your open A because then your bow does all kinds of weird stuff. You don't want to do that. Use the finger that's written on your page so that it comes out more cleanly. See, that's really funky. 103. That's man, it's like you're hiccuping. Don't do that. Use your first finger. So your second note, use your open A. That's fine. Then when it asks you to, use your fourth finger. Do what's written. Good luck. Hope to see you in the performance. That was Variations on an Irish Tune, second violin part.